CAM technology, it allows us to make the full range of cathode materials, LFP being lithium ferrous phosphate or lithium iron phosphate, NMC, which is nickel manganese cobalt oxide, and LNMO, which is a manganese-rich version of those materials. We're able to make those materials without any wasteful byproducts, and that sets us apart from the whole industry today. We can drive performance and cost, and we can reduce the complexity in the supply chain while reducing the environmental footprint. We believe that these are going to be paramount to unlocking the barriers that will put electric vehicles in everybody's driveways. And in order to do that, we need to move to millions and tens of millions of tons of material to put in those batteries, and we simply cannot tolerate the waste streams that would currently exist under the current manufacturing systems. By reducing the environmental footprint and reducing the complexity in the supply chain, we believe we can establish a very unique North American supply chain that differentiates, localizes the supply chain, and creates a sustainable, long-lasting, sticky supply chain that will, again, differentiate us from those that exist in China, these batteries. Our platform technology enables us to make cathode materials for conventional, advanced, and solid-state batteries, allowing us to address fully the whole lithium-ion battery supply chain. We have a multi-cathode strategy, and we are able to make all three of these materials, and we are in various stages of development towards commercialization, as I will walk you through. We're changing how the world makes these battery materials, and in doing so, we have developed some very unique innovations. One of them solves a current problem in the cathode material. All cathode materials have to be coated, either to improve their conductivity or improve their durability to prevent side reactions in the battery as you charge and discharge them. Unfortunately, the cathode materials tend to swell and contract as you pump lithium in and out of them as you charge and discharge the battery. And that causes them to crack and fall apart, breaking open these protective coatings and causing deleterious reactions that reduce the durability of the battery. We have developed a way to coat the individual crystals within every particle, and that as the particle breaks apart during charge and cycling, we remain protected, and it adds to the durability of the materials. This technology applies to all of our cathode chemistries, and it is a fundamental part of our platform that we call the one-pot process. We eliminate waste, complexity, cost, and environmental footprint by combining all of these materials in our one-pot process. We can go directly from nickel metal without going through sulfate, for instance. We can go directly from lithium carbonate without going through lithium hydroxide. And that allows us to combine the materials with no sodium sulfate waste stream, so we completely eliminate the barriers that are associated with that and all of the related permitting issues. And from there, we produce a powder that is then cooked in the furnace, much like it is in a conventional process, but we do it in a shorter amount of time, and we believe we can do it with much more efficient furnaces. This leads to a fraction of the carbon footprint and savings that are on the order of thousands of dollars per ton. We do the same thing with lithium iron phosphate, and this is just an example, but the facility that we are currently acquiring in Eastern Canada, in Quebec, from Johnson Matthey, uses a process that is shown on the lower part of this slide. LFP in China is made in the central part of the slide, and Nano One's process on the top, highlighted in green, is a much simplified version of making lithium-ion battery materials. It leads to higher quality, lower capex, opex, lower cost, and ultimately, we do not rely on iron precursors and refineries to make them. So we can bring this technology and this product to North America and Europe much faster because we simply don't have to build out as much of a supply chain to feed it. All of this leads to the elimination of substantial amounts of wasteful byproducts, cleaner energy, and we use far less water than any of the current methodologies for making cathode materials, basically well-primed to deliver an environmentally beneficial system. Quick summary of what we've accomplished in the last year. We completed an engineering study that is currently being shown with our automotive partners, which I'll go through in more detail. We started an LFP and lithium iron phosphate campaign in North America. And we acquired the only LFP manufacturing facility in North America from Johnson Matthey that should close in before the end of the year. We signed a joint development agreement with BASF to make their high energy density cathode materials using our one pot and metal to cam process. And we also negotiated a strategic partnership with Rio Tinto, resulting in a $10 million US investment in Nano One. And the partnership is largely centered around our lithium iron phosphate strategy. Rio Tinto have the world's largest iron powder production facility in the world, based in Quebec, just 1 hour, 2 hours north of the plant we are currently buying from Johnson Matthey. And this would potentially become the feedstock for our process. There is zero waste stream. The iron is produced in a 100% environment of hydroelectric power and is potentially the cleanest, greenest, shortest supply chain on the planet today. And we believe this will potentially be the cleanest, greenest, shortest supply chain on the planet today. And we believe this will potentially be the cleanest, greenest, shortest supply chain on the planet today. And we believe this will give us a significant advantage in North America and help us differentiate from the LFP that is made in China, leading to a long and prosperous evolution of LFP here in North America. And lastly, we have the support of the Canadian government and provincial government on a number of different projects, and has led to non-dilutive financing. We currently have a number of proposals in for more of the same. And we're enjoying very much a pan-Canadian effort to build out a supply chain to supply North America and the rest of the world. We have the support of the Canadian government, both on the natural resources side and the innovation side of the government, with an innovation center located in the west coast of Canada in British Columbia in the township of Burnaby, and then in eastern Canada in Candiac, which is just 30 minutes outside of the center of Montreal. And that's where our commercialization center will be. This allows us to create a fully integrated supply chain to support North America, to drive a very innovative ecosystem that will differentiate us and for a sustainable ESG and cost imperative in North America. We are at the core of driving change. Cathode materials defines the chemistry and defines the raw material inputs. And LFP is the fastest growing segment and will become really the launch pad for all of our chemistries in Quebec. We pursue a licensing model and a joint venture and production model. It's kind of hybridized. Licensing allows us to foster partnerships and share in the savings and promote the mass adoption of our processing technology, not only with ourselves, but with our partners and even to some degree with competitors. Our joint venture and production model allows us to demonstrate the technology at commercially relevant scale and actively participate in the full value chain with capital and know-how, and it helps us really to build, move faster, create credible threats. So we'll both drive our licensing model and lead to further production opportunities. In British Columbia, in Burnaby, it will be our innovation hub. We will, by the end of this year, we'll be operating in about 25,000 square feet of real estate. And this is where we have we've developed our ideas, our concepts, our validation, and where we're able to make sufficient materials to evaluate and optimize and jointly develop products with our partnerships. We have 24 patents currently granted, and as I said earlier, about 4 dozen pending in various jurisdictions around the world. The slide you see here right now is our Quebec facility just outside of Montreal. And we are in the last throes of closing the acquisition. It should be done by the end of this year. The plant you see here highlighted in green is a 2,400 ton per annum LFP plant. It is the only LFP plant in North America today. It comes with 45 employees, 9.5 acres of land. And our plan is to basically modify the equipment in that plant and bring it up to speed for one pot processing of LFP. The bulk of that work will happen in 2023. We also plan to expand with piloting facilities in the back of the property, and to the left there, there's expansion room for automotive scale production lines, which will become the blueprint for much wider expansion of our technology, not only in Quebec, central Canada, but also in North America with our automotive partners. 2023, we also plan to expand with piloting facilities in the back of the property, and to the left there, there's expansion room for automotive scale production lines, which will become the blueprint for much wider expansion of our technology, not only in Quebec, central Canada, but also in North America with our automotive partners. 2023, we also plan to expand with piloting facilities in the back of the property, and to the left there, there's expansion room for automotive scale production lines, which will become the blueprint for much wider expansion of our technology, not only in Quebec, central Canada, but also in North America with our automotive partners. The supply chain is evolving as you see in this kind of picture right here. A Nano One fits very neatly in the active materials just after refining and just after the recycling of the materials. We have partnerships up and down the supply chain. Rio Tinto, as I've described, is one of our key mining partners, but we also work with players like CBMM, who are the world's largest niobium producer for our niobium-coated materials, and with junior miners. A great example is Euro Manganese, with whom we are developing a process to use manganese metal directly into cathode materials without using sulfate. We also have partnerships with other junior miners that are developing, and we hope to bring those to the table in the coming months and years. Sulfate. We also have partnerships with other junior miners that are developing, and we hope to bring those to the table in the coming months and years. Sulfate. We also have partnerships with other junior miners that are developing, and we hope to bring those to the table in the coming months and years. In the cathode space, we have had a number of partnerships. BASF, we've already talked about. Johnson Matthey is a partner for their ELNO materials, and there we are largely making cathode materials using their cathode materials using our technology. We will continue to add to this list and have a number of other partnerships in the pipeline that we are looking forward to announcing in the coming months and years. We will continue to add to this list and have a number of other partnerships in the pipeline that we are looking forward to announcing in the coming months and years. We will continue to add to this list and have a number of other partnerships in the pipeline that we are looking forward to announcing in the coming months and years. We also work with the automotive companies. Volkswagen is the only one we've disclosed, but we are also working with other North American and European OEMs, and there it's contract development programs working on all different chemistries, lithium-ion battery cells, techno-economic modeling, LCA, which is lifetime cycle analysis, and CO2 footprint analysis, and plant-level engineering, and supply chain development for these various groups. Years. We also work with the automotive companies. Volkswagen is the only one we've disclosed, but we're also working with other North American and European OEMs, and there it's contract development programs working on all different chemistries, lithium-ion battery cells, techno-economic modeling, LCA, which is lifetime cycle analysis, and CO2 footprint analysis, and plant-level engineering, and supply chain development for these various groups. This brings me to my last few slides. Nano One is trailblazing a better way to make cathode materials, and that leverages not only our know-how, but our partners' know-hows, partners like Rio Tinto, who can help us address the scale-up challenges. How do we get to millions and tens of millions of tons of material in order to feed the terawatt hours of batteries that are needed to put vehicles in everybody's driveways around the world? We are innovating continuously, and we need to do that in order to solve these scale-up challenges, to solve tomorrow's problems, and address the growing market in lithium-ion batteries. That brings me to the end of my presentation, and I encourage you to reach out and contact us if you have any further questions and would like to learn more. Thank you very much, and have a nice day.